So let us understand what happens during the formation of calcium chloride. Now obviously for a calcium chloride you require an calcium atom. Okay, so let us write the electronic configuration of calcium atom. To write the electronic configuration you must know what is its atomic number. So the atomic number of calcium is nothing but Z is equals to 20. We represent atomic number by Z. Okay, so its electronic configuration becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6 and 4s2. Similarly, for calcium chloride, you require an chlorine atom. So what is the atomic number of chlorine? It is nothing but 70. And its electronic configuration becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2 and 3p5. Okay, now let us draw the diagram of an atom of calcium. Okay, so first of all we will draw the nucleus, and as we all know that in the nucleus there are 20 protons present. Why 20 protons present? Because the atomic number of calcium is 20. Now in the first energy level, guys, in the first energy level, as we can see, there are only 2 electrons present. So let us draw the 2 electrons. Now in the second energy level, as you can see, there are 2 plus 6, total 8 electrons present. And in the third energy level, as you can see over here, there are 2 plus 6, again 8 electrons present. And in the fourth energy level, there are, as you can see over here, 2 electrons present. I am purposely drawing these 2 electrons by a different color because I want to explain you something. Okay, now let us draw the diagram of chlorine atom. So obviously it will have a nucleus, and inside the nucleus, guys, can I say there are 17 protons present? And in the first energy level there are 2 electrons present. Now in the second energy level, guys, can I say there are 2 plus 6, total 8 electrons present. And in the third energy level, there are 2 plus 5, total 7 electrons present. Okay. Now, is this calcium atom and chlorine atom stable? The answer would obviously be no. Both the calcium atom as well as the chlorine atom, both of them are unstable. Why are they unstable? Because as we all know, according to the octet rule, we must have 8 electrons in outermost energy level. And if you observe the calcium atom, it has 1 and 2. 2 electrons in the outermost energy level. And this chlorine atom has 7 electrons in the outermost energy level. So guys, since both of them are unstable, they want to now become stable. So how can they become stable? It is obvious that chlorine will become stable if it gets 1 electron. Okay, so if the chlorine atom gets 1 electron, let's say it gets 1 electron over here. So now guys, can I say that it has now 8 electrons in the outermost energy level? Only if it gets 1 electron. So guys, can I say that chlorine atom requires 1 electron? Whereas if you observe a calcium atom, now you might say that the calcium atom requires 6 electrons so that it gets 8 electrons in the outermost energy level. But what calcium atom is going to do is that it has another option. What it will do is that इट विल गिव अवे बोथ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, दिस आउटर मोस्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, नाउ वॉट हैपन्स आफ्टर इट गिव्स अवे दिस टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. नाउ आफ्टर इट दिस गिव्स अवे टू इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, गाइस कैन आई से नाउ इट हैज जीरो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन द आउटर मोस्ट एनर्जी लेवल, दैट इज द फोर्थ एनर्जी लेवल. सो गाइस सिंस इट हैज जीरो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट इन द फोर्थ एनर्जी लेवल, अल्टीमेटली द थर्ड एनर्जी लेवल बिकेम्स योर आउटर मोस्ट एनर्जी लेवल. एंड एज वी ऑल नो इन द थर्ड एनर्जी लेवल देर आर ऑलरेडी 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स प्रेजेंट. सो इन दिस इज हाउ द कैल्शियम एटम इज गोइंग टू बिकम स्टेबल एंड गेन 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन द आउटर मोस्ट एनर्जी लेवल. सो गाइज आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दैट क्लोरिन एटम रिक्वायर्स 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन, वेयर एज द कैल्शियम एटम इज गोइंग टू गिव अवे, दैट इज डोनेट दीज 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. ओके, बट आफ्टर दिस कैल्शियम एटम डोनेट्स दीज 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, वेयर आर दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स गोइंग टू गो? सी, दिस 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन विल गो टू दिस कैल्शियम एटम. Why it will go to this calcium atom? Because as we all, sorry, my bad guys. This one electron will go to this chlorine atom. Why it will go to the chlorine atom? Because as we all know that this chlorine atom requires one electron. So the electron that is being donated by this calcium atom, this electron will go to the chlorine atom because chlorine atom wants one electron. But what about this electron? Where will this electron go? So to take this electron, what we are going to do is that we are going to consider one more chlorine atom. So we draw one more chlorine atom over here. My handwriting is really bad. So drawing is really bad, guys. Okay. So we are drawing one more chlorine atom. This is a chlorine atom, okay? Which has 7 electrons in the outermost energy level. So what is going to do? It requires one more electron. Now since it requires one more electron, what is going to happen, guys? This electron will be taken away by this chlorine atom. So guys, as you can see over here, both the 2 electrons lost by the calcium atom are taken by 2 chlorine atoms. So one calcium atom is losing 2 electrons and those 2 electrons are taken by 2 chlorine atoms. So now let us see what will be the new diagrams of this calcium as well as chlorine atoms. Okay, so for that, see, first of all let us draw this calcium atom. See, it has 12 protons in the nucleus. Then in the first energy level, it has 2 electrons. In the second energy level, as you can see, it has 8 electrons present. And in the third energy level, it has another 8 electrons present. And now in the fourth energy level, it has no electrons present because both these electrons which are earlier present are donated by this calcium atom. So now there is no need for you to draw the fourth energy level. Whereas this chlorine atom now becomes 17 protons in the nucleus as it is. Then in the first energy level, it is going to have 2 electrons. In the second energy level, it has 8 electrons as it is. Now in the last energy level, there are changes. There are these 2 electrons, then these 2 electrons. Earlier it was having 7 electrons, but now this one electron gets added. Okay. Now, if you want to represent this chlorine atom, how will you draw this chlorine atom? Just like this one only. 17 protons. In the first energy level, there are 2 electrons present. In the second energy level, there are 8 electrons present. Okay. And in the third energy level, there were earlier 7 electrons present. And now this one electron is going to get added. Okay. So I am showing this one electron that is added. Now, what happens due to this? See, earlier this calcium atom was having 20 protons and 20 electrons. So, as can I say that the positive charge is equal to the negative charge. And since the charges were balanced, therefore this calcium atom was neutral. But now it has 20 protons and it has now 18 electrons. Now, due to this, what happens is that, guys, can I say that it has plus 2 charge more? The positive charge is greater by 2, so it has more plus 2 charge. See, it has 20 protons, which means that there are 2 protons. 2 protons are extra. So, guys, can I say it has plus 2 extra charge? Okay, therefore, this calcium atom now becomes Ca plus 2. Okay, so it will have now positive 2 charge over here. Okay, after that, this calcium atom earlier has 17 protons and it has 17 electrons. Okay, now since the positive charge is equal to the negative charge, therefore, this calcium atom was neutral. But now, what is happening over here? Now it has 17 protons, but it has now 18 electrons. So, guys, can I say that the negative charge has increased? So, minus 1. So, since the electron has increased, therefore the negative charge has increased. So, guys, can I say that now the charge is exceeded by minus 1? So now we are chlorine atom becomes minus Cl minus, or you can write it as Cl minus 1. That is one and the same. Okay. Now for this chlorine atom, same thing is happening. It has now 17 protons and 18 electrons. So as can I say that the charge has now exceeded by minus 1. See, one electron extra. So minus 1 extra. So this Cl minus 1. Now, see what happens is that we now have, let me repeat over here, Ca plus 2, we have Cl minus, and we have Cl minus. Okay, now as we all know that opposite charges attract each other. See, this calcium is positively charged and both of them are negatively charged. So since the opposite charges attract each other, therefore, guys, can I say that there is an electrostatic force of attraction? Electrostatic force of attraction between the positively charged Ca plus 2 atom and the negatively charged Cl minus ions. Okay, so the Cl minus ions are going to get attracted towards this Ca plus 2, and a bond is formed, and this bond is called as an ionic bond. So this bond, see, all three of them are coming together. See, let's say these are Cl minus, Cl, this is also Cl minus, this is also Cl minus, and this is Ca plus 2. So they all will get joined together. See, now since there is a bond developed between them because of the electrostatic force of attraction, and that bond is nothing but your ionic bond.